In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss a programming question known as last stone wait. So this is the LeetCode day 12 challenge problem, and the problem statement is, given a collection of stones, each stone has a positive integer weight, and in each turn what we have to do is we have to choose the two heaviest stones and smash them together. And suppose these stones have weight x and y, with x is less than equal to y. The result of this smash is, if both the weights are equal, in that case both stone are totally destroyed. If both the weights are not equal, in that case x is totally destroyed, as the weight of x is less than equal to y, and the stone of weight y has a new weight, which is y minus x, and at the end there is at most one stone left. So we have to return the weight of this stone, or zero if there are no stones left. So let's understand this problem through an example. In the input, given a collection of weights, so we have an array of weights and we have to perform some operation. And what operation we have to perform? We have to pick two heaviest stones. So the two heaviest stones are this one, 7 and 8, and then we have to smash them together. So when we smash them together, if the weights are equal, then both the stones are totally destroyed, and if it is not equal, then x is totally destroyed and the weight y has new weight, which is y minus x. So when we take the difference, so it is 1, and you can see the weight 7 and 8 is removed from this array, and the new weight, which is 1, is put back in this array. So after the first operation, the array is like this, 2, 4, 1, 1, 1. And again, we have to repeat this process. We have to pick the two heaviest stones, and now the two heaviest stones are 4 and 2, and again they are not equal, so we have to smash them together and take their difference. So 4 minus 2, which is 2, and after this operation the array is 2 1 1 1, and we put their difference back, which is 2. And after that, let's the two heaviest stones are 2 and 1, and again let's do the operation, and it is 1. And this time, so we remove these two and put their difference back, so now 3 times 1. And let's pick other two heaviest stone, which is 1 1, and they are equal, so they are completely destroyed, and after that only one stone left, and this is the output. So 1 is the output. So this is the problem statement, and now let's think how we can solve this problem. To solve this problem, what we have to do is to remove the two heaviest stones, and then we have to calculate their difference, and after that put their difference back, and we have to repeat this process until 1 or 0 element is left. For example, the two heaviest one are 7 and 8. We have to remove these two weights, we have to calculate their difference, and their difference is 1, and then we have to put 1 back in this storage. So we have to repeat this process until 1 or 0 element is left. So we need a data structure from which we get the max element at the top. So out of all the element present in this data structure, we get the max element at the top. For example, now the max element is 8. So when I remove 8, the next time when I poll this data structure, I get 7. After that I get 4, like this. So here we can use the priority queue to solve this problem. So to understand priority queue, let's think of a queue. So queue is a first in, first out data structure. The element which we enqueued first is the first element to be dequeued. But in priority queue, every element has some priority associated with it, and the element which has highest priority is the first one to be removed from this queue. And the elements of the priority queue are ordered by default in natural order. So what is the natural order means here? So it means when I put all the element in a priority queue, so the element which is which has lower which has minimum value is to be polled first. So natural order means simply means ascending order. So first is the so first mean, then second mean, then third mean, then fourth mean. You can imagine like that. But to solve this problem, we need the max element at top, so that when we poll, we get the maximum element. So what we can do is we can pass here the collections dot reverse order. What it can do is it will reverse the natural ordering of the priority queue. So the highest element has the highest, so the element which has max value has the highest priority, so it will be polled first. Then what I am doing is I am putting all the elements in a priority queue. So now when I put all the elements in a priority queue, you can imagine it will be arranged like this. It will be arranged like 8 7 4 1 2 and 1. So basically it's a max heap implementation. And so let's not discuss the max and mean heap implementation in this tutorial, as it will complicate the tutorial. Let's imagine like this. So when I put all the element in a priority queue, it will be arranged like this, and then I am running a loop. So I am running a while loop until the size of this priority queue is greater than 1, and then I'll pick in each iteration I pick 2 elements, and then I do their difference and put them back in a queue. So the 2 element will be polled as 8 and 7. So 8 and 7 will be removed from this queue and their difference will be put back. So after the first iteration, let's imagine this will be like this, 4 2 and 1 1. So in next iteration again the 2 max element will be picked, and we do their difference and put them back in a queue. So after that it will be like 2 1 1 and 1, and again we pick the 2 max element and then do their difference and put them in a queue. So it will be like 1 1 1, and then again I pick the 2 max element and put them in a queue, and it will be 1 0. And then again when we put them in a queue, so it will be 1, and then we came out of this loop. So let's see this condition: when the size is greater than 1, then run this loop. So this time the size is equal to 1, so we came out of this loop and we return the element present at the head of this queue, and which is 1. So the output is 1. So now let's talk about its time and space complexity. So its time complexity is O and log n, as we have to maintain the sorted order, and the space complexity is also O n, as we have as we are using extra space. And so this is the one way to solve this problem. And now let's see the main method. So in the main method, I'm constructing an array of weights, and then I'm calling this method and I'm printing this result. And if I run this code, you can see the output is 1. So that's it for this video tutorial, and for more such programming videos, you can subscribe our YouTube channel. You can visit our website, which is https://webrewrite.com, and please don't forget to like this video. Thanks for watching this video.